cried the woman. And you've bitten me, heavens, why? You know your bite is poisonous, and now I'm going to die. Oh, shut up, silly woman, said the reptile with a grin. You knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in.
Hello, hello. This is Flat Earth Boxer, and I'm just going to give a breakdown of why the vaccine is very plausibly the mark of the beast from the Bible. So this is the first page of the Bible, describes the creation of the world and the animals and the plants and all that and the luminaries. And when you get to the sixth day, it says, and God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beasts of the earth after his kind. And it was so. In Hebrew, it says, Ve'omer Elohim totseh ha'aretz nefesh chaya lamina behema. Okay, that word behema is cattle, all right? I'm going to go to the interlinear. Behema, cattle, you see? If I copy this word, behema, and go into Google. Paste, behema. Let's see what we see. Livestock, cattle, cows. Let's go here to images. Cattle, cow, beasts. Let's just do a straight neat no knee could. Behema. Cattle. All right, so we have that. Let's look at the origin of the word vaccine. V-A-C-C-I-N, vaccine etymology. Maybe I should have started with this, but the origin of the word vaccine comes from the word vaca, which means cow. Vaccinus, vaca, cow. Interesting. So let's go here. Let's go back to, now let's go to the word mark. Let's go to Ezekiel chapter 9. We're going to go to verse 4. And God said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that are done in the midst thereof. It says in Hebrew, Ve'omer Yahovah, and said God, Ailo eber betok ha'ir, go through the midst of the city, betok Yerushalayim, through Jerusalem, v'chatovit tav, sorry, get that out of the way, v'chatovit tav al metzachot hanoshim, ka na'anakim va ha na'ankim al kol ha to'abot ha na'ashot betocha. So that word here is tav, which is the word for mark, as you'll see. Tav, you see, set a mark. Whoops, let's go back. And set a mark. Sorry, I lost it. Bear with me. And set a mark. Tav. A mark as a sign of exemption from judgment. In this case, in the book of Ezekiel. Tav. So if I take this word and I put it into Google. Set the keyboard to Hebrew. Tav. What we see, colloquially, the word is note or sign or line. And here we have just a dictionary definition. But if you look right here, the first link outside of a mere dictionary definition is a corona.government.israel website where it says in Hebrew, Mahu Tav Yog, what is the green mark? Atar Rmzor Kona. See here, emblem of corona. Mahu Tav Yog, Matoret Hatav Yog, Hu Lechwot Aishor Kenisa. Ebeor me chalamim va me tekasonim. I know that word means vaccination. And if you go here you see vaccine passport, tabulok. And this is what you put in your phone and you display on your phone in order to be allowed to engage in, you know, activity. So if I type in here, it's literally hatav, which is to say, again, let's go back. Let's go back to Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 6 now. It says, slay utterly young and old, both maids and little children, and women, but come not upon any man on whom is the mark, and begin at my sanctuary. Then they began at the ancient men which were before the house of before the house. And that word here, if we go back to here, on that word, the mark, you can see I've highlighted it. That word is analogous to this word right here, hatav. Hatav, the mark. And what do you get? You type in the mark into Google, you get corona.government.israel, government.israel. It says, Charachavet hatav hayok b'shevel rashon ma. Something about the first of something. And here you go, you get the idea. Green mark, vaccine passport stuff. That's a sitch. And I don't know. I mean, it should be very straightforward. Imagine what would happen if I did this, if I typed in the mark, and what came up was American vaccine passport stuff. You know, people would take notice. But if you type the mark in Hebrew, hatav, the first thing that comes up, it's vaccine passport stuff. See if you get anything there. Yeah, vaccine passport stuff. As you can see, it's about the virus. All right, now we can go a step further. If you go into the New Testament, go to Revelation chapter 16, I think it is. Obviously, the New Testament was originally written in Greek. Well, at least I don't know if it was originally written in Greek, but the preserved text that we have, which is the translation base for the King James, is the text that's Receptus Greek. And here it says, and I heard a great voice come out of the temple saying to the seven angels, go your ways and pour out the vials of the wrath of God upon the earth. And the first went and poured out his vial upon the earth, and there fell a noisome and grievous sore upon all the men which had the mark of the beast, and upon them which worshipped his image. So you see this phrase here, mark of the beast. If we go to the oldest translation of the New Testament into Hebrew, Revelation, so it says, Galot Yochanan, Tetvav, which would be 15 and through 16, Yodvav, chapter 15 through 16. And we go here to chapter 16, right? You see this is Yodvav. Here we have the same verse. This is verse 2. It starts by Yilek, Harashon, Vayishpak, Et, Sin Sinto Ba'ares, Vayehit Petzare, Ra, Vemera, Al Ha'anoshim, Asher Lechem Tav Habehemah, upon whom is the mark of the cattle. Tav Habehemah. And what's the root of the word vaccine? It's vaca, which is behemah. And the Tav, this is the Tav. I don't know how to make it any more clear. Like, it's all in your face. And now you know. And please share this with anyone who you think would be edified by it. Just don't take the facts, guys. At the very least, it's the 666 vaccine. Like, just consider this. You type in corona. Corona. It's 66. And it's also a six-letter word. Like, just... I don't know what to say, guys. All right. Have a good day. Hope that was edifying. Be well. Bye.